Can you think of any scientists who have also been statesmen? APJ Abdul Kalam, whose projects in space, defense, and nuclear technology guided India into the 21st century, became our 11th president in 2002. In his autobiography, Wings of Fire, he speaks of his childhood. I was born into a middle-class Tamil family in the island town of Rameshwaram in the erstwhile Madras state. My father, Jainul Abidin, had neither much formal education nor much wealth. Despite these disadvantages, he possessed great innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. He had an ideal helpmate in my mother, Ashima. I do not recall the exact number of people she fed every day, but I am quite certain that far more outsiders ate with us than all the members of our own family to put together. I was one of many children, a short boy with rather undistinguished looks, born too tall and handsome parents. We lived in our ancestral house, which was built in the middle of the 19th century. It was a fairly large pakka house made of limestone and brick on the mosque street in Rameshwaram. My austere father used to avoid all inessential comforts and luxuries. However, all necessities were provided for in terms of food, medicine, or clothes. In fact, I would say mine was a very sacred childhood, both materially and emotionally. Every child is born with some inherited characteristics into a specific socio-economic and emotional environment and trained in certain ways by figures of authority. I inherited honesty and self-discipline from my father. From my mother, I inherited faith in goodness and deep kindness, and so did my three brothers and sister. Then the Second World War was over and India's freedom was imminent. Indians will build their own India, declared Gandhiji. The whole country was filled with an unprecedented optimism. I asked my father for permission to leave Rameshwaram and study at the district headquarters in Ramanathapuram. He told me, as if thinking aloud, "Abdul, I know you have to go away to grow. Does the seagull not fly across the sun alone and without a nest?" He quoted Khalil Gibran to my hesitant mother. "Your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of lives longing for itself. They come through you, but not from you. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts, for they have their own thoughts." APJ Abdul Kalam, an extract from Wings of Fire. Thank you for watching this video.